Want to know more on connecting instruments such as a bass guitar to your mixer? Coming up. After the last video, we felt na kailangan pa namin pag-usapan further yun about connecting, let's say, a bass guitar to your mixer. Na sinabi na nga natin, line level yon, and you use a DI. But there are situations where you're not more than 15 feet away from the mixer. Let's say, meron ka lang, meron ka studio sa bahay, or meron pang jamming lang naman, and all that. So, minsan, hindi ka naman ganun kalayo. And what you'd probably do is connect your bass guitar straight into the line level input of your mixer. But recent designs of mixers, such as sa RCF and sa Mackie mixers, not only do you have a line input, a simple line input, meron ng included rin a high Z instrument switch. You activate the high Z input kapag instrument na isasaksak nyo. Because you've got your mic level and your line level, pero yung instruments actually it falls somewhere in between yung voltage niya, but yung impedance niya is quite higher. Now that impedance difference, when you put in a instrument into the line level but with a higher impedance than the usual line level, may affect yun sa sound. So here in this video, we'd like to show you, actually we'd like you to hear the difference between what it is to connect a instrument such as a bass guitar. We'll connect it into the line input with, as if taking it as a line level signal. Then we shall put it into the line input pero with the high Z switch activated. And then we'll move on to the instrument being connected to a DI. Okay, so we're now here in our setup. The objective again is for you to hear the differences between an instrument being brought in via the line input, a line input with the high Z switch activated, and then the other one would be your, you know, the standard DI. This exercise, we even suggest that you wear headphones so that you'd be able to hear better yung mga detalye, di ba, ganyan. Our setup is simply a mixer na everything being equal, but mapapansin nyo, yung gain natin sa line level mataas-taas, and yung gain dun sa channels na may high Z at saka may DI, they're practically the same. Okay, so now we'll go first into the line level input. Okay, now we go to the line input with the high Z switch activated. Lastly, we go through the DI, phantom power activated, powering the active DI. Maririnig niyo yung mga yung differences, especially with the line versus the high Z switched and the DI input activated. So if you appreciate what we're doing, please like our videos. If you love it, please share it, and see you in the next.